pushing. We got into Alpha Lab. We did a bunch of cool stuff, had a lot of cool customers. I will do the whole 5 minutes on all that, but I'll plug Greg. We're going next week with them to DC, being one of the top 40 startups to come out of the university. Services, but we can talk about that later. I want to talk about what John asked me to talk about, which was kind of things I wish I had known when I was sitting in the audience where you are now. Granted, this is a much nicer room than the old unused calculus lab that we started this thing in. I really liked that old room, you know? It had a charm, there was a ping pong table, those chairs looked very nice, but you could daisy chain a few monitors together. It was, I liked that. Anyway, before I diverge again, so I'll just put this, so kind of mistakes we've made and things I knew right away. I guess right off the bat, because you're all going to face a wide series of problems throughout your startups. They'll be generally consistent. Funding doesn't change anything. You just have the same problems, but usually just more of them. So I'll start with a book recommendation and get that out of the way real quick. Ben Horowitz's The Hard Thing About Hard Things. If there's only one book you read, read that. And startups nice too, it's fine. But that's a book that tells you about all the problems you're going to have and how to solve them. Really right, it's a book about being a CEO and creating solutions that aren't a band-aid that'll turn into a hammer later on. So the second thing, and probably the single most important thing I was ever told when I was starting this thing, granted much later, but I wish I kind of had that mindset from the beginning, is that the most precious resource you have as a young, early stage company, it's not funding, that's always nice. It's not advice, that can be very useful. It's not your technology, not even co-founders. That's a complicated thing that we can talk about over beer sometime. But it's time. Time is always going to be pushing against you in the sense that you only have so much time before, say, funding dries up, you only have so much time before you have to meet this deadline, you only have so much time before you or your partners, you know, need a job that pays you. Those are kind of nice, especially as time moves on. So that's probably the single biggest thing I wish I should. I'll also share with you some of the worst advice I ever got. Not here. The advice here isn't half bad. It's okay. Some people will tell you, especially at an early stage, that traction is traction. And I really disagree. You know, we got ourselves into some situations where we wasted a bunch of time where we, you know, sure, we were doing a thing related to our business that made us a bunch of money, but it wasn't the right traction. Particularly if you're going to raise money, a savvy investor will look at your numbers, and if, say, you're making money doing a thing that, say, you know, that wouldn't be the idea they're investing in, well, they'll just brush it off. And there were times where, you know, those first customers you have, it's always so exciting, and you want to keep pleasing them, and they'll say things to you like, hey, can you do this too? And it's irresistible because the same customers give you more money. But to do something that's a little bit unrelated to what you do, we almost got into the social media business, which, but there's also a little bit of value in exploring that as well. Not to contradict the advice I just gave you, but sometimes when you really find the market that is perfect for your particular product or your solution to a problem, it can be from very unexpected places. For us, we saw particular segments where there's an enormous need, zero willingness to pay. And it took us a while to kind of figure that out. There were segments where need, but they pay you far below than is really economically viable. Sometimes I can pay a bill if you can learn something for your product. For us, what really turned into that perfect kind of use case for our company wound up being subtitles. We've done a whole slew of TV shows, some documentaries. I think something you can watch right now. If you look up Mel Industries, all their stuff, at least most of it, we've done subtitles for. And that's been a pretty cool thing, and that's got us into some great conversations with big companies that I can't tell you about, but maybe next time I can make exciting announcements like Noah. So I guess, I don't know how long I've been talking, but those are kind of some of the big things and problems and things I wish I knew when I was sitting where you are now. I'm gonna have to leave early, but I might be able to stay for a few questions and they have my email. Really make the most of this. It's like I said about time. This program, which has evolved tremendously since my cohort, there's a lot of people that want to help you, to really give you good advice, and don't waste any of that time while you have this. We couldn't have done it without these guys. I think that's true. Particularly because I started this out talking about how I wouldn't have done it without them withholding money. So, but just keep at it. We've mentioned about leaving your company earlier. Once you're into this, this might be your first company, but it will not be your last. And just go at it, have fun. I'm available to help you guys, not just here. I mean, when I say send me an email, there's a lot of guys that came before me that helped me out and have